Michael Jackson, the king of pop, was one of the most influential and successful musicians of all time. Throughout his career, he was known not only for his musical talents, but also for his complex personal life. One aspect that often garnered attention was the nature of his love life and his links to famous women. While some of these relationships were confirmed, others remain shrouded in mystery and speculation, many of which we have covered on this channel. In this video, we will attempt to shed some light on this aspect of Michael by picking out some of the most intriguing and often revealing details about the women in his life, as revealed in our previous deep dives. Links to all videos mentioned will be linked in the description box below, so we highly recommend you check out any of those if you are interested in learning more. Here's the detail. Unrequited love. From our video focusing on their relationship, Michael Jackson and Diana Ross, their untold love story, Jackson biographer J. Randy Tartarelli recounted that in 1977 while shooting The Wiz, Michael Jackson and Diana Ross would regularly go out at night attending parties and New York's Studio 54 nightclub. One of Diana's assistants said he had been trying to get hold of both of them all morning as they were late for filming. Eventually, they got hold of them on the phone and was surprised to find they were in his apartment and that she had apparently spent the night there. Later on, during the shoot, Diana was apparently overheard talking to some girlfriends of hers and said to one of them, quote, "Well, I'll tell you one thing, Michael definitely isn't gay." When this assistant asked Michael if anything had happened between them, Michael said, quote, "You'd have to ask her that." And when he asked Diana, she told him he needed to ask Michael. This flirtation between Michael Jackson and Diana Ross would continue for years to come as Michael's infatuation grew, but Diana never took the relationship seriously because of their 13-year age gap. Although this was never an issue for Michael, Diana, on the other hand, could not overcome the taboo of the age and their association when Jackson was a child. She was fearful of how this would impact on her public image. This unrequited love affair continued for years in Michael's eyes, and he was left devastated when Ross met her second husband, Norwegian shipping magnate Arne Næss Jr., in 1985. The two married the following year, and Michael Jackson apparently canceled his attendance to the wedding at the last minute. Quote, "When I heard Diana Ross was getting married, I was happy for her because I knew it would make her very joyous. Still, it was hard for me because I had to walk around pretending to be overwhelmed that Diana was getting married to this man I'd never met. I wanted her to be happy, but I have to admit that I was a bit hurt and a little jealous." First public kiss. Michael Jackson reportedly had a short love affair with his co-star on the 1987 music video for the single "The Way You Make Me Feel," Tatiana Thumsen. They got close while filming, and the pop superstar subsequently invited the model/dancer to the shoot of his "Leave Me Alone" video before inviting her to perform with him on his Bad World tour. However, tensions built when Thumsen landed a spontaneous kiss on Michael Jackson's lips while on stage at Madison Square Garden in New York City. Thumsen would then appear on The Tonight Show with host Ross Schaefer. Quote, "He asked me, 'So are you and Michael really dating?' I replied, 'No, we're not. Our relationship is strictly professional.' He insisted, 'Oh, come on.' I repeated my answer, and once again, he insisted with the point that we were dating. I thought I would add a little humor and some mystery, so I responded by saying, 'No, we're not. Not yet, anyway.' It got back to me that Michael did not like my response." Joe Jackson recounted that the onstage kiss was a strike against her, but, quote, "When she spoke on a talk show about her relationship with Michael, Michael's manager decided that was enough. She was immediately fired. We knew that he had romantic feelings for her, but we certainly did not utter a word about it since it was not clear. If this relationship was serious or not, Michael was sad because he had to let her go." Proposal for marriage. Michael Jackson stated several times that him and Brooke Shields dated on and off for many years. However, soon after Michael Jackson found himself at the center of a salacious press thunderstorm when Jackson faced charges after a 13-year-old boy accused him of child molestation, Jackson was under pressure to do some major damage control as an attempt to repair his tarnished public image. One suggestion was that he had to get married in order to promote a more conventional, heterosexual image. Therefore, during a phone conversation with Brooke Shields, Michael made a serious proposal of marriage to her. But at the time, she was dating the well-known tennis player Andre Agassi, with whom she was in love and later married in 1997. But she wanted to have a somewhat private life and knew what Michael was going through, even before any false molestation rumors started, and didn't want to be a part of that lifestyle. When Brooke declined his offer, Michael Jackson then went on to ask Lisa Marie Presley to marry him instead, in which she accepted. When asked about Michael Jackson's marriage to Lisa Marie, Brooke stated, quote, "I think we're not dealing with convention, so somebody like Michael, he's not going to just fall in love with somebody and get married. I think there were a few people that he could identify with, and what I know about Lisa Marie, she was very sweet. She could identify with him. They could talk about things that I'm sure she understood with regards to her father." Love after divorce. Michael Jackson's most high-profile marriage, on reflection, is often portrayed as a two-year flash in the pan. But according to Lisa Marie Presley, the couple continued their love affair long after their official divorce. Even after Michael remarrying and the birth of his first child, him and Presley rekindled their romantic relationship as she quickly became the artist's main focus once again. Presley was seen with Jackson in various cities during the History World Tour in 1997, notably at various functions in South Africa and in London, holding hands backstage and around the city. In February 1998, they were photographed in an intimate moment together outside a Beverly Hills restaurant on Presley's birthday. Their on-off relationship was fueled by Lisa Marie actually chasing Michael, sending him letters that read, "I will give you 9 children if you want. I will do whatever you say." But Michael saw she was too strong-minded and didn't want trouble anymore. He had his children and didn't see the need for a wife. Presley said that they spent 4 years after the divorce getting back together and breaking up, stating, quote, "I don't understand the relationship I had with him." If you are new here, hit subscribe for more Michael Jackson documentary-type content. Like this video and let us know if you enjoy this type of format and what other topics you would like to see from us. Until next time, see ya.